everybody. Delayed our departure this morning because I've been talking with the planners. Trying to solve problems from the weekend. All the regular shift people, you know, the regular bosses. What happened? What happened with this and what happened with that? It's like, I don't know. Talk to your planners. And all I said was, it was a weekend. What do you expect from the weekend? But at least we got free parking. I should cut some of these bushes down. So it was originally supposed to be picked up on the 14th. And it's supposed to deliver today by 1. Obviously that ain't happening. But we can only do what we can do. We did update the 70-hour clock. Oh, and I just remembered we forgot our Sunday video. Dang it. Oh, well. So what we'll do is go get coffee at the Quick Trip. Because there is no truck stop between here and the shipper. Now, the place that we deliver to, you know, some places you could show up late and they work you in, you know. The place that we're going to, I'm 99% sure they work on appointments only. But, I don't know. That's something we threw back in the boss's lap and says, here, you figure it out. What do you want? I like being able to just throw everything back in the boss's lap and say, here, you figure it out. You tell me what time to be there and we'll make it happen. Yeah. about ready for some Atlanta traffic Monday morning. over, FedEx. You can give the other people room to move over.
Thank you.
idea who that is. Betty Joe Williams. I needed to be over there, didn't I? Protect Pleasantdale Road. I saw that dang sign. I knew it. Well, Pleasantdale Road is what we wanted. Oh, we'll come up here and do a swing around. Why they make roads so goofy? You almost don't see that sign because of the trees in front of it. Just do a U-E. Now, the thing is, I wonder if I can swing this around. Probably not, right? I don't know. It depends if there's two left lanes on the other side or not. left lanes. There's one or two, but I need this other one. Two cups of coffee this morning. Yield, buddy. Two cups of coffee. Some days I don't want to drive a truck. Yes, I know, all the super truckers are probably making fun of me. Oh, he should know how to do this, and he should be perfect, and all that, but you know what, so what, I don't care. Maybe I'll care after I get my coffee. And yes, I do have a percolator in that truck, but this was kind of on the way. So, you know, it is what it is. Does have good coffee, and they've got great lunch, and they've got great donuts and everything. Come on, I need over and you need over, but neither one of us are gonna do anything. You sit right beside me. There we go. I love it when people go the same speed as you and demand you move over. It's like, well, I need over too. Neither one of us are going to win if you sit there. I haven't had one in a long time, but the QT's got a cucumber chicken sandwich, which is really, really good. Thank you. big truck jumping a car. No, it looks like that car is jumping the big truck. That'll kill your battery. All right, it's daylight. Get all these trucks out of here. How y'all doing?
Welcome to Big Rig Travels, your guide to the American highway. Big Rig Travels live broadcast. We hope you're enjoying the ride as we take you across America on the longest running road trip ever. Make sure you click on subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know whenever we go live. Don't forget to stop by the BigRigTravels.com website to learn about this trip and visit the BRT store and pick up your favorite shirts and the official Mash It mug.
Hey John, how you doing? Troy, howdy. Tom, howdy. Hey look, it's M.A. Sute. M.A. Sute from across the pond in Scarborough, England. Doyle, Gus, howdy, howdy, howdy. Matthew, howdy. Oklahoma, how you doing? We ain't been to Oklahoma. Wow. Skeeter man, Lazoid, it looks like you got a mosquito. Or is it a lizard? Who would want to buy a picture of my mug? Thank you, Doyle. Howdy, Super Caitlin. Ouch. Come on. I don't want you to just walk out in front of me. Oh, you're going to a garbage can. Here I was waiting because I didn't want to run you over. Well, if we pull forward, ain't nobody going to get past us. So I guess might as well just sit here. Buckinghamshire in the UK. David, howdy. Hey, I'll be right back. Let's go get coffee. Ouch. Oh, these bones. Wow, this is one massively busy store. Oh, wow. Well, we got good coffee, so what counts? Dude, you're coming in backwards. Where are you gonna go? You're coming in backwards too, dude. Where are you gonna go? See, they need to have more truck stops around here. They really, really do. Massive metro area. A ton of freight warehouses around here. North side, south side. But they don't want to give nobody any parking. And that's just like, you know, that doesn't work. Gonna go or what? What? You gonna go or what? You better go. There's no, you're not gonna get beside me. What? Run you over. So we run up on the curb. Come on, y'all dingleberries, go. Go! Wake up. I can't go till you do. Yay. Intelligent Georgia Power. All right, so let's enjoy our coffee. So we were going to get some donuts, but man, the donuts got picked over. doing this trip now. They just took it away from us. So I don't know where to park for a truck stop up north to even pull over and talk to the people. So I guess we'll continue to go around to Zana. That way we can pull over and call dispatch and see what's going on. Let's go. Damn. Sure, I put on my blinker and then you floor it. Just to get beside me. That makes me mad. I think it ought to be a $500 ticket to do that. They're perfectly fine staying like just behind you a little bit. Put on that blinker to speed up and sit in the middle. So now what are these people going so slow for? I can understand the weekend being screwed up because nobody works the weekend, but it's Monday. All the bosses should be figuring out what's up now. said that was a Santa Claus dog.
Thank you.
know what we're doing. I don't know what's going on. We'll pull into the petrol here because it's the only place to park. And get on the phone and or send messages or whatever. And see what we're doing. Actually, we'll probably do a phone call. And see what happened for the weekend. What happened today. We'll leave the trip up because they say it needs to be rescheduled. Duh, I told them it needed to be rescheduled for delivery, not for pickup because it's a preloaded trailer. And the message says, don't pick it up. We need to reschedule. Why would you need to reschedule a preloaded trailer? So I don't know what we're doing. I don't know. I know you guys want answers, and so do I, but I don't know. It's a Monday. For the last, ever since we got back in the truck from the dealer, or from the repair shop, ain't nothing gone right, you know? Hopefully we get an answer before. Thank you. Look at the line of people trying to get out. You can't even get to the parking because of people. What is this? Everybody's evacuating or what? All these are reserve spots, even way out here. I mean, right where you're at, dude. Thank you. So, you want me to leave the camera going for a little bit or what? Let me mute you guys, because I think the boss sent me a message and he says he's going to give me a call in a few minutes. So, I don't know what we're doing. I don't know if we're keeping this trip or if we're not, or I don't know. So, I'm going to mute you guys. You guys get to watch whatever trucks roll by if you want. As soon as I find something out, I promise you I'll let you know. Sound like a winner? You guys could watch though if you want. Gossamer, quit throwing a toolbox around. So, we got a if John wants to, because I'm not, if John wants to update the trip journal, or trip, whatever it is, trip, it's picking up in Atlanta and delivering in McDonough. And since this, so that's all I know at this time. And we drop, preloaded drop. Okay.
6'4". Okay, so...
Hang tight, we'll get rolling here in a minute. It's already almost noon. Dang damn it. Thank you. Okay. Let's go. Okay, let's go. All right, ready to go now. All right, let's go. Remember where we started this morning? That's where we're going right now. We're going to go pick up another trailer and deliver it in Mondano, Georgia. That's where we go. It ain't that far of a trip, but it's something. And we got the boss. Nice long talk about what all happened this weekend. I see Marco in the chat room. Marco, if and when you do something, with a map or whatever, and we're working on it or something, can we make it where it doesn't require an origination point and all that stuff? In other words, a lot of times we have just from point A to point B. This trip being a perfect example. We pick up in Atlanta, which is where we originated from, to McDonough. Or if we're going from where I last delivered, say we deliver in, oh, I don't know, give me some little town in Illinois. Say we deliver in Bloomington, Illinois. And then we go to Belvedere for time off. That's not, you know, what in, we almost forgot that car. Do something, little cart. We need to do something where we could do just two legs of a trip, if that makes sense. See, this is why we came down here, because the line to get out the gate is all the way down here. Now, hopefully we weren't here 2 hours. If we're here 2 hours and we have to pay for parking, $20. I see this little flatbed thing, whatever it is. Messed it up because now nobody coming in can get in until he gets out of the way. This ought to be like Ontario, where you have two gates to get out. Or the TA or whatever. I don't know what the problem is here. It's always difficult to get in and get out. And what do you think we're all waiting for, you big dummy? Haha, now you gotta back up. So this guy thought he was gonna go around us. But then he realized that, gee, there's a line here. Fancy truck started beeping at us, thinking we're sitting here for our fun. So what is the timestamp? Timestamp is 10:26. So as long as we get out of here before 12:26, we're all right. Why is nobody moving? no fighting in chat. Everybody just trying to help each other out, that's all. Everybody's only trying to help. Nobody jump on nobody else. Oh man, Rusty's looking for the toolbox again. See, we would have never got out, never got out if we continued straight. That's why we came back here to get in line, because you would never let you out. Chase all the squirrels. What's temperature? I don't know. It says 80, but that's just because I'm not moving. I don't know what the actual temperature is. Maybe we'll get a good weather thing fixed back. We need to. See, we really can't update Nightbot until we get all the other stuff worked out. It'll happen. We'll figure stuff out. If I wanted to pay $99 a month more, we could, I think. Or maybe it's even more than that. We just dished out $4,000. New hosting. Yeah, 64 and sunny is probably right. So y'all, we're gonna run around the whole loop. We went across the top part of the loop, now we're gonna run across the bottom part of the loop. What's going on at the other end up there? Why are you getting eaten? Start chomping back. Lock her in a room with Nelly. Nelly will fix her. We did talk to the boss, and they're gonna cut us a couple extra checks for all the trouble and miles on trips that got canceled and the whole nine yards. So even though we won't get mileage paid, they're still gonna cut us exemption pay. And they're really good at that. We just have to explain what happened and all that stuff, and my boss is really good at finding extra money for me, so. That was funny when my boss says, "Why did you end up, or how did you end up in Georgia?" It's like, I don't know. I took a wrong turn in Albuquerque. Come on. We take turns. Unlike the guy that tried to go around us because he thought we were just sitting there. That other truck thinks he's gonna cut me off. We take turns. That means I go, you go, we go, you go. Does that mean three of you people come out? You could wait like the rest of us. And you wonder why. See, and this is after all the other trucks have already left. Think about everybody trying to come in here at the end of the day. It gets to be one big cluster. I have sat out on the ramp waiting to get into this truck stop in years past. We actually had our CB repaired at that CB shop many years ago. Cost me $200, more than what the CB cost. But we had it amped up a lot. See, it's one guy to do the inbound and outbound. Why not stick two people in there? One for the inbound and one for the outbound. Instead of just one. If you lose your parking ticket, there's $100 fee. $100 fee if you lose your ticket.
Oh, I'm crazy.
All right, you too. At least we've been dragging this clean trailer around. Since we got out of that shop, it's just been a cluster of squashed pecans. For those that say they want to be a truck driver just like me, this gives you a good example when things go awry. Actually, it ain't bad. We still got a job. We still got our health. We still got a road crew. And Sonny got coffee. We're alive, so I guess it's all good. This too shall pass. Y'all saw the top of Atlanta this morning. Now you get to see the other half of Atlanta.
Dragging an empty trailer around the country.
actually it's 100 miles more because it's 100 miles round trip around 285 loop. So add another 100 miles on top of that. So that's almost 1,000 miles this weekend with a silly empty trailer.
Thank you.
5,000 coins, which obviously will have to wait. Yeah, that's what I said. That's what I meant. got to do a trailer swap. And then we'll head straight down to delivery, all right? See you in a minute.